Hi folks, today's subject is G6PDD safe treatment of colds, coughs, and fevers. Before we get started, I would like to invite each one of you to like our video, to subscribe to our channel, and to leave comments below in the comment section. Those comments are very important to us and help us to figure out what we're going to do next, and we'll be happy to answer any questions that you want to ask down there. Okay, let's get started. One issue with G6PD deficiency is that common drugs for colds, coughs, and fever are unsafe to take. I read just today about Tylenol's effect on the liver. Apparently, it doesn't take very long for this to happen, and we just can't afford to damage our liver. It is under enough stress as it is due to having to deal with hemolysis. Aspirin has been on a avoid list ever since I can remember. And paracetamol has multiple possible problems. See paracetamol in the drugs to avoid list on their website. And to make matters worse, most child liquid meds have alcohol, artificial food colors, artificial flavor, and other chemicals in them which are also on the avoid list. Okay then, if we can't take over-the-counter drugs, how do we deal with colds, coughs, runny noses, and fevers? I wish I had a dime for every time I was asked this question. Let's look at them one at a time. Colds and flu. A cold is caused by a virus and cannot be cured with drugs. It has to run its course. What affects the length and severity of a cold the most is our health and immune system. If we don't avoid triggers, follow the diet suggestions, and eat right, the cold will be worse and last longer. We will recover from hemolysis slower. Some viruses can cause hemolysis, which complicates matters and makes it even more vital that we get and stay healthy. The only thing we can treat are the symptoms. Clogged and runny noses. This one is actually pretty easy to treat. Simple salt water or saline solution, as it is called at the pharmacy. A few drops of saline solution nose drops will not only help unclog the nasal passages, but will help fight germs and nasal infections as well. There are no side effects and it can be given as often as needed. For older children and adults, you can use a saltwater nasal rinse. There are recipes online and you may be able to find a prepared solution at your pharmacy. Cough. This is also surprisingly easy to treat. For children under 1 year old, juice some pineapple and add a small amount of lemon juice to it. You can also add some powdered ginger if you like. This works as well or better than commercial cough medicine, has no side effects, and kills germs to boot. For children over 1 year old and adults, add some local raw honey to it for even better results. And for the stout of heart, you can add some cayenne pepper, my personal favorite. If you don't have pineapple juice, you can substitute apple cider vinegar. You will need to add honey to offset the vinegar taste, so this is not for children under 1 year old. Fevers. Let's talk about fever for a minute. There are a lot of myths about fevers. A fever actually helps the body fight infection. So it is not a bad thing unless it gets too high and stays there. For fevers under 102 degrees Fahrenheit, leave them alone. If it gets higher than that or stays for several days, see a doctor and find out what is causing the fever. If there are other symptoms that are alarming, also see a doctor. If you need to reduce a fever, a tepid bath or sponge bath will help reduce it and has no side effects. For more information, see Fever Myths on the website. Natural remedies are usually much safer and many times are actually better than prepared medicine. So don't panic when your child gets sick with colds, coughs, and fevers. There are G6PDD safe recipes, over 300 of them as a matter of fact, in the member section for these and other natural remedies. Plus some awesome soup recipes to keep your spirits up. Folks, thank you for watching my video. I really appreciate it. I would please like our video, subscribe to our channel, and leave comments. Thank you again. See you next time. Bye-bye.